Hi everyone, this is Dan Julien, nurse practitioner for Danesthetics Medical, and our clinic is located here in Ottawa, Canada. Today's topic, blindness due to dermal fillers is extremely rare, yet it's on everyone's mind, clients and injectors alike. What if I could tell you I can give you a few tips to decrease that chance significantly, almost to zero? Well, that's what we're talking about today. Let's get into it. So recently I had the pleasure of attending a dermal fillers conference, and it was hosted by Christian Subio, plastic surgeon. Highly entertaining guy and very knowledgeable. I highly recommend anyone in the medical aesthetics field to go check him out during one of his lectures. You'll learn a lot from him. And the one thing that really stuck out for me was his approach to doing liquid rhinoplasties. I do enough liquid rhinoplasties, and deep down, even though I'm being as safe as possible by staying either on the bone or perichondrium and staying midline, there's always that slight hesitation. Is there a risk that I potentially could be partially in an artery? Is there a risk that maybe their artery isn't quite placed where it's supposed to be? Maybe it's a little deeper, maybe it's a little off center. And you have that fear. It's a high risk zone. So what he mentioned and really opened up my eyes and how I changed doing liquid rhinoplasties is this study that was done by Duke University. Basically what they did is they took cadavers and they took the supratrochlear arteries and they looked at the thinnest point to the thickest point entering the eye, and they looked at the volume of each of these arteries. And what they found is that the volumes range from 0.04 mils to 0.12 mils. And that means that you could potentially occlude a supratrochlear artery, which may result in blindness, with as little as 0.04 mils of filler. What is that? This is a BD syringe. This is 4 units. 4 units is basically 0.04 mils. It's not a lot. So that opened up my eyes significantly. And basically what Dr. Subio is saying is, listen, as long as you're being safe, and if as long as you understand that it can take that much, then don't do a bolus bigger than 0.04. And on top of that, if you want to be even safer, do a retrograde. Start at the perichondrium or periosteum, place your needle right to the tip, make a plunge of 0.03, but make that needle move. Therefore, there's no possible way that you could fully occlude an artery, and therefore almost virtually guarantee you never having the risk of causing blindness to someone. So now that we have this knowledge, what can we do with it? How can we virtually guarantee ourselves never having the risk of causing blindness in the future for any of our clients? Well, basically, we have to look at the arteries that really lead to blindness. We have the supratrochlear artery and the supraorbital artery. These arteries go up to the forehead for the most part. So whenever you're doing forehead filler, A, I always use a cannula. I go perpendicular. My cannula is going to be 25 gauges or higher to make sure that it's not going to be able to penetrate through the artery. And at the same time, I'm going to make sure that I'm not going to sit there and place a bolus larger than 0.03. I'm basically going to keep that cannula moving, and that can virtually guarantee no major issues. Two other arteries that lead to the eyes are the dorsal nasal artery and the angular artery. We've already talked about this one and how to prevent complications of that, but this angular artery connects to the facial artery and runs parallel or just around that area of the nasolabial fold. So how can we treat that and be as confident as possible that we're not going to cause any occlusions? In the past, you've probably seen some of my videos where I talk about going deep down to the bone of the piriform fossa and placing a large bolus there, and then after that going in and doing some retrograde techniques with a more superficial and light type of product here. Well, now that I've learned that it doesn't take almost any product in order to occlude an artery, that in combination of now implementing an ultrasound machine in our clinic, it's really opened up my eyes in how I treat nasolabial folds. When I'm doing the ultrasound here in the angular artery, it's supposed to be very superficial. And for the most part it is. But once in a while, we'll have a client come in and that angular artery is actually much deeper than I thought. And I've heard of other providers who also use an ultrasound machine, and they've seen that artery go extremely deep. And it's a possibility that if you end up using a dull needle, you can potentially push that artery right down to the bone. You can pin it there and just occlude it with a bolus of any filler of your choice. So for those two reasons, I've now switched my technique. And what I do is basically a multi-level technique using a cannula. It gives me a really nice result, and at the same time, it assures me and my client that they don't really have to have worry or risk of occlusion and potential blindness. The other bonus of it too is that there's really almost no downtime. Because of the cannula, you don't really have to worry about any bruising. So that's it for me today. For all the providers out there, I hope this added to your skills and repertoire. For anyone else in the community, yes, I'm happy that you're here learning about the real risks of medical aesthetics as well. There are risks, there are a lot of benefits, but you should be aware of both. And if you have any questions or concerns, feel free, send me a message. I'll be more than happy to respond to you. Until the next time, take care of each other, exercise daily, and please, be nice to absolutely everyone. Take care, guys.